The title Animal Kingdom, was that something that was stuck in your head from the very beginning, or what made you decide on it?
Originally, the script was called Jay, you know, after the main character, and I knew that would change pretty early on because, I edited a magazine for a number of years and kind of knew that one-letter titles get lost in print, you know. But also because I wanted the film to be, I wanted the title to be suggestive of a much larger world than just one kind of central kid. I wanted the film to be about an entire spectrum of, you know, good guys and bad guys and everyone in between.
Was it fun, like, subverting, certainly for the British, their expectations of what Australia is? Because I think a lot of people think, oh, it's Neighbours and Home and Away. That's essentially what it is. There's the outback, but that's essentially what it is. Was it fun showing a kind of a darker, deeper, richer side too?
Well, I kind of find it surprising to hear that, given you sent us to where we are as criminals in the first place, you know. But I don't recall ever kind of setting out to represent Australia in any particular way. Right. There was just a kind of rich criminal history in Melbourne especially that I really wanted to explore. And, you know, I kind of like the fact that, I remember when I'm doing press for the film in America, and every now and then people would say, well, you know, I now have this terrible image of Melbourne, and, you know, and your kind of tourist authorities must not be happy with you, you know. And I'd say, well, I beg to differ, because I remember when I saw Scarface for the first time, all I wanted to do was go to Miami, you know. When I saw Taxi Driver, all I wanted to do was go to New York. Yeah. And in fact, when I finally got to New York, I was disappointed to find that it wasn't anywhere near as dark and dangerous as, you know, the New York of Taxi Driver.
Were you trying to put together a real story rather than a kind of an imagined Hollywood version of it?
There was, certainly it was my aim for Animal Kingdom to feel, you know, kind of raw and authentic, you know. And when you start engineering a film of that nature, you know, one that takes itself very seriously, it's difficult to find room for sort of wallowing in blood and guts. Mm. You know, it's, you know, violence in the real world, I think, is something that explodes out of nowhere and is rarely anticipated. And it's kind of frightening suddenness that violence kind of functions as an event in life, as it does in the film, I hope, where, you know, it's an event that turns people's lives upside down. But the event itself is over in a flash. You know? I knew that, you know, I mean, in any kind of dramatically structured script, that stuff has to happen, you know. Yeah. But even I didn't anticipate how effective some of these moments in Animal Kingdom would be, you know. When we were in, you know, took the film to Sundance, and which was the first proper audience of just strangers we were able to put the film in front of, to see how those moments played was, an incredibly gratifying surprise. The first audience made up almost entirely of people who didn't know me personally, who couldn't care less about my feelings, you know, and who just basically reacted however felt appropriate, you know. And so that kind of buzz that started to build around the film at Sundance was, you know, was really exciting.
Are there any other, you know, ideas that you'd like to bring to cinema?
An entire world of options have opened for me, which is incredibly exciting and terrifying at the same time. You know, I'd just love to make all different kinds of movies. But having said that, I have no idea what the next one is, you know. I mean, I have some ideas, but, I don't want to talk about them.